Hello everyone, and welcome to my Emmerdale News YouTube channel. I hope everyone is having a wonderful day. Before we begin, please hit the subscribers button and give this video a thumbs up. For a brief moment in Emmerdale, Kane Dingle understood the true meaning of happiness when Nate Robinson formally acknowledged him as his father. As viewers are aware, Nate entered Kane's life 4 years ago. Feeling that he had been cheated out of a father, Nate tried to teach Kane a lesson by luring his own stepmother, Moira Dingle, into bed. Remarkably, Kane found the fortitude to forgive the son he didn't know he had, and the two went on to develop a semblance of a relationship. However, it seemed as though the father-son team had achieved a significant advancement in this area when Nate chose to address Kane as dad in front of him. For a little period, Kane felt warm and fuzzy, and tried not to show it. But soon, there was sorrow since a positive relationship with his son Nate means a negative relationship with his brother Caleb Milligan, William Ashe, who has been lost for a long time. Fans will remember that last year, Caleb started an intense relationship with Tracy Metcalf, who was Nate's wife at the time. When Nate and Kane learned of it, they were both furious and quickly distanced themselves from their brother. But gradually, things warmed up between the two siblings. In fact, Kane even paid Caleb a visit in the hospital this week after his surgery. Though Kane's admission that they just cannot be in each other's lives, he must support Nate, broke Caleb's heart, despite his initial optimism that this was a positive indication for their relationship. Nate, who is acting utterly hypocritically considering what he did when he first came to the hamlet, has made it very evident that if Kane allows Caleb into his life, there would be no future for them together, which is why the mechanics severed their relationship. However, it turned out to be even harder than Kane had anticipated. Later, the tough guy was seen yearningly gazing at his brother, for whom he has a great deal of affection, despite the fact that he would never be in his life. "Ah, Kane, I swear I'm not sobbing. Maddie Barton and Amy Wyatt of Emmerdale will have a near miss next week as their wedding is nearly called off at the last minute." The pair is taken aback when Amy's mother Carrie's careless actions jeopardize their special day. Carrie has pledged to cover the ceremony's costs, but in later episodes, Susie Merton, the events coordinator, gets concerned because the money hasn't yet been transferred. Carrie is hoping to sell her diamond necklace for a big amount of money next week, but she's having trouble getting a good offer. While Carrie concentrates on gaining a second opinion on the necklace's value, she hides from Susie. Susie finds Carrie and threatens to call off the wedding if he doesn't make the payment before the end of the day. On the eve of the ceremony, Susie and Layla Cavanagh established Home Farm, putting their trust in Carrie's words. Even when Maddie and Amy arrive for the wedding rehearsal, Carrie hasn't given them any money yet. Straightforward Kim Tate states unequivocally that she needs the venue paid in full and as soon as possible. Carrie is devastated to get such a small payment for the jewelry back in the village. She tells Eric Pollard the truth about how Amy's hopes will be dashed and that she cannot afford the wedding. Carrie prepares herself to break the heartbreaking news on the wedding day. She lets Amy and the other guests know that she is unable to pay for the ceremony. When Maddie learns that the wedding is called off, he is devastated by this most recent setback. Thankfully, Layla promptly proclaims that the wedding is back on when she gets a mysterious call. When Maddie and Amy joyfully exchange vows, who will make sure they have the wedding of their dreams? Rona from Emmerdale lost her cool in court, pleading with the jurors to accept her version of events rather than her kidnapping of Ivy, but viewers think she might be winning. Fans of Emmerdale are certain that Gus Malcolms committed a grave error that might spell the end for him. Alan McKenna's character Gus has been involved in a contentious custody dispute with Rona Goskirk for several months. It will be clear to viewers that Ivy is Rona's biological daughter, having been conceived after Gus and his wife, Lucy, used their frozen embryos to conceive. Sadly, she passed away during childbirth, and Rona started to feel a bond with Ivy. Rona and Ivy ran away with Gus after discovering he was planning to relocate to Kananda, but they were eventually apprehended for kidnapping. On Thursday, Rona made her court appearance on the ITV soap opera. However, she jeopardized her freedom when her motivation for kidnapping Ivy was investigated. "Quite frankly, the law is an ass," she screamed. "I apologize, but he embezzled from me. He didn't offer me the opportunity to speak out or the chance to dispute when another lady gave birth to my child. And now I'm being accused of kidnapping and abduction when I try to voice my opinion about how that child is raised." Ronan declared to the jurors, "It's insane. Ivy is my child in every meaningful sense, and you have to realize that my sole reason for taking her was my love for her. She's my kid," expressed Premium Banner. Emmerdale fans notice a courtroom mistake following Rona's outburst, which sealed Gus's demise in Emmerdale's while pleading with the jury to accept that she didn't kidnap Ivy. Rona lost control in court, but fans think she could be winning. Emmerdale. Gus grins when Rona snaps. Fans of Emmerdale are certain that Gus Malcolms committed a grave error that might spell the end for him. For months, Alan McKenna's character Gus and Zoe Henry's character Rona Goskirk had been involved in a violent custody dispute. It will be clear to viewers that Ivy is Rona's biological daughter, having been conceived after Gus and his wife, Lucy, used their frozen embryos to conceive. Sadly, she passed away during childbirth, and Rona started to feel a bond with Ivy. Rona and Ivy ran away with Gus after discovering he was planning to relocate to Cananda, but they were eventually apprehended for kidnapping. On Thursday's program, Rona made her court appearance. However, she jeopardized her freedom when her motivation for kidnapping Ivy was investigated. "Quite frankly, the law is an ass," she screamed. "I apologize, but he embezzled from me. He didn't offer me the opportunity to speak out or the chance to dispute when another lady gave birth to my child. And now I'm being accused of kidnapping and abduction when I try to voice my opinion about how that child is raised." Rona declared to the jurors, "It's insane. Ivy is my child in every meaningful sense, and you have to realize that my sole reason for taking her was my love for her. She's my kid." Gus was grinning from the gallery when Rona lost her frigid anger. However, viewers think that his smug actions can come back to bite him. One commenter on social media expressed their opinions by writing, "Like the jury can't see Gus smirking in the courtroom, hashtag Emmerdale. Someone, please wipe that smirk off Gus's," yelled another. "Don't overlook. Rona's barrister needs to tell the judge about the smirking or even announce it to the whole court," voiced a third opinion. "See who will be grinning in hashtag Emmerdale then. The smirky looks they're giving each other across the courtroom, hashtag Emmerdale," another person said. "Gus is guilty," said someone else. "I detest Gus. Not too arrogant for too long, matey." Gus then made even more fun of Rona by implying that she would be going to jail. Gus approached her outside the court and congratulated Rona. "We didn't need to get the drug addiction to stick. The jury finds you to be insane, and you offended the judge." He concluded by saying, "Bring a bag tomorrow, because you won't be going home." Thanks for watching if you liked this video. So please don't forget to subscribe my channel and don't miss any update.